This conference will now be recorded.
Try to start our discussion on Kubernetes. Okay, so what is Kubernetes? So we already have a discussion of Docker Swarm, okay, which is nothing but cluster orchestration tools. Similar to Docker Swarm, Kubernetes is also a cluster orchestration and management tools. Okay, so here we talk orchestration and management tools. And then it is developed by Google and laterally given to this open source community. Okay, what are all the things that we can do with the Docker? We can do with the Kubernetes also. Here what we need is here we are going to set up a Kubernetes cluster. So using a default pre-configured box. So here a sandbox. So here that configuring a Kubernetes cluster involves certain tedious set of commands, and to what we need a system with high configurations. Here the Kubernetes, in terms of its architecture, it is a master slave architecture. Then we have one master server and we have multiple slave machines where the actual process runs. Okay, similar to that of you have a Docker master and Docker slaves. Here what we are going to do here is, in today's session I will let you know environment sandbox, which was provided free. Okay, so in this following check, kindly make a note of this: https://labs.playwithkubernetes play-with-k8s.com. Okay, here what you need is, you need a login ID. Either you have a Docker public hub account, okay, you need to have a Docker hub account, or you need to have a GitHub account, okay, using this both login IDs, okay, any one of this login ID, we can make a login into this. Now, I had a login into this Kubernetes, okay, so here using my Docker hub mail ID, so this is the labs icon, playwithkubernetes.com, okay, here. The session by default will be provided to you for 4 hours. Within that 4 hours, you can do all the activity as of our requirement. So why we are going up with this? So the only first thing is, it is a little bit difficult in setting up Kubernetes. Okay, you need to have a lot of understanding. So what I do in the next session, I will share you a script. Okay, if you want to set up, you can run the script similar to that of Docker. So nobody will ask you how to install Kubernetes and so on. Here the thing is that, as a DevOps engineer, you need to do orchestration by using Kubernetes. That is the role for a DevOps engineer. Okay, this installation is not a role. Here those things will be taken care of by system network administrators. Okay, so here the second thing is that you need a higher end machines. Okay, minimum for our server master, we need a machine with 4 GB, and for slaves we need a machine with 2 GB. And we need minimum of 4 microprocessors recommended and 2 microprocessors recommended. So if you go this sort of setup, you need to spend minimum $2 to $3, okay, US dollars per hour of our session if we go up with the AWS. Okay, so what we can do, another option is, we can go, if you have a Google account, you can go up with login with the Google Cloud. So Google Cloud almost provides $300 free of cost. In terms of INR, I think so it is around 20,000 rupees in Indian rupees. So I will let you know how to get an account in Google Cloud and how to launch this multi-cloud cluster. Okay, so today we can far away practice what are all the things that we can do with this real setup, can also be done on the following sandbox, which is provided free of cost. Here it is maintained by Docker. Okay, this particular sandbox is maintained by Docker with the help of another company. Okay, so here this master slave applications of this Kubernetes with respect to this particular link here, it is maintained by an application called Kubenet. Okay, it is maintained by an application called Kubenet. Okay, so this is the application which maintains this. So how to set up this cluster? So you can make a login into this and we can do all the activity as of our requirement. Okay, so this is the login that you need to go for. So here https labs playwithkubernetes.com Okay, if you make a login, it will ask you for credentials, Control C, Control V. Okay, it will ask you for credentials. So here you want to give play with Kubernetes, a simple interactive to learn Kubernetes. Okay, so this is the lab side product by Docker, which is created by a company called Tutorials. So here you can able to launch these clusters. Okay, then it uses Alpha and Linux variant. Okay, so these are all the some of the statistics associated with what we are going to do. So if you make a start, what happened here? It will ask you for a username and password. Okay, since it will ask you for a username and password, you need to give the credentials of either the GitHub or you need to give the credentials of Docker Hub. So, okay, so if you give the credentials, it will take you to this following format. So this is the way by which you need to go up with sending up the cluster. Okay, so here I already, since I had already a session, I closed this session. Got it. So here we have a session which is currently running. Okay, so totally 4 hours will be given to us. Now what we are going to do, we are going to create the following setup. We are going to create a single master and two node. Okay, you are going to create our master, Kubernetes master. We are going to create two nodes. Okay, worker node one or slave node one or worker node two. This is the setup that we are going to do. Okay, so how to go up with this setup? So you connect with this. Click on add a new instance. Okay, click on add a new instance. It will create a node. You can find you have a node one with the IP 192.168.0.0. Here the node will have its following configuration. Okay, so here 192 totally, here how much of memory, 4 GB of memory is allocated, out of which 1.3% has been utilized, and for CPU, one CPU, so almost 50% of CPU has been utilized. So this is the command, initialize cluster in master node. So if you launch a Docker, you want to configure your master. Okay, similarly here too, you need to configure a master using this following command: kubeadmin init -nps server advertise address okay postname. This is the command that you need to you want to go up with. So kubeadmin initialize API server. So you want to type this command. After that, what you need to do, you want to set up this. Okay, you want to set up this for your Kubernetes network. Once you create the master, the second command that you want to do is you want to create a Kubernetes setup networking. So for that, you want to make use of this command. Let me first copy the command and place it in a notepad so that we can make use of it. Copy and paste. HTTPP, this is the site you want to go for to create a that is a cluster free of cost. Okay, go to this site. You need a credentials. You need either Docker Hub or GitHub username password to login. Okay, so the command that we want to make use of it here is how to copy this. So to initialize a cluster master, cube admin in API server advertise where you need to run. Okay, Arun. So you want to run this on the server. Okay, so after that you need to configure this cluster networking using this. Laterally you can add your nodes. Okay, similar to that of creating a token for node, here too there is a token using which you need to add a node. So this is the command. So you want to go for this. Kubernetes. Create a. Okay, this is another deployment that you can make use of it. So using this YAML file that we will discuss. Okay, let me first add this, and laterally we can go for the remaining thing. Okay, so here you have created this node. Okay, so next we need, this is the master, it is going to act as a master. You create another node, click on create node. So there is a second node. Okay, and here click on the third node, node 3. So here we have node 1, node 2 and node 3, out of which node 1 is going to act as a master. The remaining two nodes are going to act as slaves, okay, with respect to Kubernetes. So this is the setup that you can do. The same setup, I will let you know how to do in AWS Cloud or in Google Cloud. If it is AWS Cloud, you need to spend minimum of around $3. Okay, this is your master, Kubernetes master node. These are your slave 1 and slave 2. Okay, so here if you want to connect with slave, simply select this, then this is connected with this slave. Okay, so what you need to do? Here you want to run this command on master, go to the master node. Okay, this is your master node. Here in the master node, what you need to do, you want to run this command. Okay, you want to run this command onto the master node. Please make a note, the setup is okay. This is our node. Okay, so node 1, if you click on, you will be connected with node 2. This is your node 2. Simply click on, so you will be connected with node 3. So you have node 1, node 2 and node 3. Okay, so let me make it here. Let me first connect with this node 1, and I am going to make it as a master node. Therefore, what you need to do, the command is kube, it is being managed by this application kube admin init API server advertise address, automatically the IP address of this corresponding hostname, $hostname-i, what it will give? So it will give you the IP address, control C, it will give you the IP address of this machine. Okay. So this IP address will be taken and it will be redirected here. Okay. So this IP address has been taken and it will be redirected. You can find the IP 192.168.0.1 will be given. So here this command, what we can either directly give this IP instead of $hostname. We can directly give the IP, both the thing will work fine. Okay, so here you are giving the host name is completely different from IP, you aware of. Okay, so right click, copy, you can run this command directly here in this node. I want to run this command in this node. So now we can find, so here it is enabled as a master. Okay, this machine is enabled as a master. So here you can perform this action before and Kubernetes config images full. So what we need to do, so here hostname, okay, init api-server, docker service is not active, system control docker services, okay, so system control start docker services -, let me first note this command, Okay, it is a warning. It is not mandatory. It is a warning. If you want, you can run this laterally. So please make a note of this command. It is a best practice to go for adding to start a Docker. So Docker starter service system control start. Finally, make a note of this command. Docker dot service. So it will start. Okay, and then pulling images required for setting up this Kubernetes cluster. Okay, so it depends upon some time and based upon this internet speed. Okay, so now our cluster is started. Now we can find waiting for API server Kubernetes application. Okay, daemon set configure. Okay, so here you can find here to deploy. Okay, to make this node, the worker node to join into the cluster, you want to add this. To make this node to join into the cluster, you want to add this. Please make a note. This is the command that you need to have. Right click, copy to join a worker node. To join the node as a worker node, use this command in that worker node. Okay, cube admin join. This is the token generator to join as a worker node. Okay, servers. Kubernetes underscore level 519 Saturday. Okay, so now we have initialized this cluster, and after that what you need to do, you want to initialize the networking for the cluster. Okay, the step two, it will once you initialize the cluster, so here this token is generated to make another node as a worker node. Okay, so before joining this, let me set up this networking. Right click, copy. Connect with this machine. Okay, to create a network. Now the network is created. Pwnet is created. Daemon set extension. Yeah, network setup has been created. So once you issue this command, so now my server is ready. Okay, what you need to do? So now I need to add another node as a worker node. Please make a note. Okay. So here I need to add the remaining two node as a worker node. Therefore, you just copy the command. That is the token that is created while you execute this command one. Okay. Copy and connect with this worker node. Okay, this is your node to simply paste this command. So before okay, so executing, so if you type you go to this node, so if you want to list out what are all the nodes that it is present, then you can make a verification. Kube control get nodes is the command. Kube control ctl get nodes. Please make a note. Kube control get nodes is the command to list what are all the nodes. Now you have only one master node. Okay, to list, let I make it to list all nodes in Kubernetes cluster. The command is kube control node list. Okay, so will give you the list of all the nodes. Now you can find you have only one node. Okay, node one, the status is ready, node is master. Average the node version with Kubernetes version 1.11.3. Okay, the age of node, it launched 4 minutes back. Next, what I need to do, I want to make this node to join as a worker node. Enter. Okay, it took some time. Being it is an internet, it took some time to make this node to join as a worker node. Similarly, I can also make this node 3 to join as a worker node. Okay, so now let me add these two nodes and wait for some time. Okay, now Kubernetes get nodes on this master to see the node join on the cluster. Now you can find under the master node, if you run the same command, now these two nodes, the Kubernetes get node got added. Okay, so here this is master and these are all slaves. Node 2 is ready, node 3 is yet to ready. Let me verify. The node 3, it took some time, it all depends upon your network. Yes. Node 3 also, now it is ready. Let me make launch this command the same node. Now you can find the status of all the three nodes was found to be ready. One is master, these two are worker nodes. Okay, now we have set up the cluster of Kubernetes. Okay, so let me go for in the refresh something. Okay, in terms of Docker, how we do, we download the image of Docker, using which you can launch a container. There is a hub called dockerhub.com. Okay, from the Docker hub, it will maintain all the images. Here too, we can make use of this Docker images. Using that, you need to download an image. Okay, based upon that image, you can launch a container. Okay, the container will run the needed services. Here too, the setup here is similar to container. Here we have the container has been embedded into another service called pod. Okay, so pod is a major service under which you can encapsulate. Container is encapsulated. So once again, pod is not a single entity. It is under the control of a controller. So with respect to this Kubernetes, there are two types of controller in Kubernetes. Okay, one is replication. We will discuss about what are all the differences between. In terms of controller, there are two types of controller. One is replication controller. Another type of controller is replica asset. These are all the two types of controller. Okay, the controller are responsible for maintaining the Kubernetes API. And they will control, the controller's responsibility is to control the pod and the container coming under the pod. Then the entire thing will be here controlled by another service called deployment. This is the hierarchy. We have deployment. Under deployment, we have controllers. Under controller, okay, so this is the main service which takes care of the entire Kubernetes. Deployment consists of several controllers. The controller we can configure either as a replication controller or as a replication set. Under a controller, we have an entity called pod. Under pod only, we have this container. So this is the container where we launch your service. This is the hierarchy that it is followed here. If you do some activity on the pod, so what are all the containers? The pod can contain multiple container, one container, two, up to n number of containers. Each and every container will run a service. If you apply some command on port, it will be applicable all the container which is coming under the port. So under controller, we have multiple port. Port 1, okay, port 2, port 3, etc., etc. So under deployment, we can have multiple controllers. Controller 1, controller 2, controller 3. So this is the hierarchy. So if you apply on this controller a particular command, what are all the ports which is coming under the controller, and what are all the container which is coming under that port will be applicable. Okay, we can't directly apply any command straight away to the container. You need to apply the command on the port where the container got embedded with. A single port can run multiple instances of the container. Okay, so in a general word, port is an application whose responsibility is to maintain the state of the container. Okay, these are all the some of the things associated with the hierarchy of this Docker. So hierarchy of this Kubernetes cluster. Yes. So what is the responsibility? We said the port is, as of now, the port is taking care of maintaining all the activities on the container. Okay. So let me start a application to start a server. Okay. So this is the command. So we start the nodes in the cluster. Let me start Nginx server. Okay. So to install the nodes, this is the command to start. Nginx. To start Nginx server, the command is, so in terms of Kubernetes, kubectl run. So let me make it as a web server. Okay, I need to give a image. The image name Nginx. Okay. Equivalent command is Docker run. Okay. In Kubernetes seems similar to kubectl Docker run. -- name. You want to give a name the web server. So to run in a detached mode -d, then you can specify the image name. This is the equivalent Docker command. Okay. Just a recall. Here Docker run. The name is optional. If you want to assign, you can assign a name is equal to web server. Here what you need to do, being it is a web server to run in a detached mode -d in a detached mode, okay, you need to give the image name. So this is the equivalent command. This is your image name. Okay, the image can be get from Docker. This is the name which is optional. If you don't give this name, automatically Docker daemon will assign a name here too. Kubernetes control web server is the name, logical name assigned to the container and using the image. Okay, so it will launch the web container with the following thing. Okay, so let me do this first. So we copy kubectl run web server. So where to run this? You want to run this on the server. Simply copy, go to the server. Let me remove. Go to the server. Now you are under the server. Simply right click, paste, kubectl. Okay, run web server -- image Nginx. Okay, now we can find deployment dot apps dot web server is created. Okay, so under deployment here this web server is created. So how you can get this information? Okay, kubectl get nodes will give you what are all the nodes that is under the control. So kubectl get ports. Kubectl get ports will give you all the ports which is under the control. Now we can find to have a web server with one instance which is running. Okay. To list this. This service, the command is kubectl. Okay, similar to that of get nodes, get ports. Kubectl get ports. So if you want to get more information, what you can do, you can go up with the option, with the wide option. It will give you more detail. Okay, so along with this IP address, where it is running. Okay, we can give -o as option, a wide option. Okay, so let me get the difference. Kubectl get port will list you. Kubectl get -o option will give you a little bit more details. So kube control get ports will give you only the name of the services and the number of instance, the status. If and O option will get you more information where it is running, under the node 3 it is running, what is the IP address, the IP address. Okay, so these are all the things that will give you a detailed where it is running and what is the IP address of the corresponding node, how you can access using the, okay, will be given if you go with this option of fine. Okay, so that we run the application server and do a host port mapping here. Okay, let me create an app server. How to create a Tomcat server and map the port. Okay, the command is kubectl. Okay, so what is the command? You want to issue the run is the command. Then let me make it as app server. This is the logical name. I need to give the image. So what is the image? The name of the image is Tomcat. Okay, so this image, Tomcat image, I want to specify the port, -- port, which is the port where Tomcat is running, that is your pod container port. Here I want to make it a mapping with host port. Okay, I want to specify the host port as 1990. Here in this Docker, what we do, simply we do this host mapping -p, so followed with 8080:1990. Okay, this is the way by which we do this port mapping. So this is your, okay, so here this here comes your container port, here comes your host port. Okay, so this is the port where we can able to access the service. So this is the container port. So this is the way where we do map port mapping for the same service. If you type this IP address colon with port number 1990, you can access this Tomcat here. Kubectl on application server -image Tomcat. Here I want to specify the port, the container port. Then I want to explicitly give a keyword host port to specify the host port. Okay, this is the way by which you need to create a service by doing a port mapping. So let me do this. Now deployment of app server has been created. Okay, so let me verify Docker ps-a. Now you can find, again, if you are Docker ps-a command, it will give all the details. So here we have this Kubernetes cluster. Okay, all this Kubernetes cluster is running. Apart from that, we have this app server and another servers are running here. Okay, so if you want this information, kubectl get ports. Kubectl get ports. It will give you those services. Okay, it is now a container is in a creation state. The app server, it took some time for creating. Okay, so it all depends upon your internet speed. So now the container, if it is created, so it took some times for this. You need, if you have a higher end machine and a good networking, then it will now you can find the status up and running. Now you have one application server and web server is running here. So I will let you know how to create this thing on a Google Chrome, okay, on coming classes. so that you can make access by typing the private IP. Okay, let me do this. Next, let me launch MySQL. Let me do the practice of how to apply, supply an environmental variable. So, create a MySQL database. Okay, the command is kube control. Okay, run. I need to give a MyDB, okay, a logical name. So I need to specify image, iPhone, iPhone image. I can specify MySQL, the latest image, :5. So here I need to pass the environmental variable iPhone M. So if you recall, MySQL _root_password. Okay, so this is the password environment variable that I need to go for. Let me make it as 0. Okay, so after that, if you issue this kube control port, it will list you. Copy, go to the machine. Okay, so simply paste it. Now it will create a MySQL deployment. So now it will be getting ports. Now you can find 3 services. Okay, the MyDB is now creating, and it took some time to create. So to open an interactive terminal, what you need to do? So here you can open an interactive terminal to get connect with any one of the ports. To get connected with the VoiceThread containers. Okay, this is the command. Okay, so kube control. Execute is the command to run in, okay, -it interactive, and then you want to give the code name. Okay, what is the name of the code that you need to give? Then this is the shell. Okay, bash. So here the code name, you can get this code name from the file. This is the code name. Okay, if you issue this kube control get ports, this is the name of the port. Okay, so you want to give the code name. Now if you make a note, kube control get ports, now the status is found to be ready. Okay, so if I want to connect with this, you can connect it. To get the lock, kube control locks, okay, -F, once again port name. To get the locks, kube control. Okay, you want to specify locks -F, you want to issue the name where you want to get the lock. Okay, so let me connect with this. With any one of the port. Okay, let me copy. Control V. Let me open a pad. Okay, let me connect with this. If you want to connect with the my database, right click, copy. Control V. Okay, bash. Now you can find it got connected with this particular container. Okay, please make a note. Now the connection front has been changed. Now you can connect with this MySQL. Now you can find. So here MySQL -u root -b. Then it will ask for the password. The password that we have assigned to the environment variable is true. it will connect with that the particular container. Show databases, we can work with this. You can create a database, okay? So you can do any activity, create database. Database name, that I make it the database name as 06. Okay, now the database has been created. 06 to connect with that, use 06. It will take you to the database. Okay, show tables. It will give you another table present. Let me create a table. Create table employee. Okay, with the employee number as an integer, employee name as a string. Varchar. So it creates a table. Now insert into table name values. You can insert values 1, RAM. Okay, comma 2, so line by line insert into table values, employee, insert into table values, okay, so select, okay, so this is the way by which you can simply come out of it. Okay, so now you are under the container. So this is the way by which you can create to come out of it. Simply exit will take you to the zone. Okay, to come out of the container, simply type exit. To come out of the container running in the background, control P and control Q. The same thing that we make use of in Docker. Okay, so these are all the, so to get this lock, cube control. So what is the command? So here locks, and I want to specify hyphen F, a code name. Okay, sorry. The code name is, let me go for a code. Okay, here we have a code name. My database. Copy and paste this code here. It will give you the lock set. What are all the locks that it is associated with that code will be given here. This is the way by which you can start a cluster with one master and two nodes, and you can configure the needed services on top of it. Okay, so here in Docker we have a Docker file, which is a YAML file. Similar to the Docker, Kubernetes also have a YAML file. Here we can create ports in Kubernetes using YAML file. Okay, so here it will follow the same syntax. What are the things that it follows here? It will be following the same syntax. Okay, the YAML file, it is optional. Okay, it starts with triple. Okay, so and it can end up with, it is optional. So intermediately you want to specify something here. Okay, so here it should have an extension dot YAML. Here it contains four top fields. With respect to this Kubernetes YAML file has been contained, it contains four top fields. One is this API version. API is a case sensitive API version. And another one, you want to specify the kind. Okay, through the key value kind, whether it is a pod, whether it is a container, whether it is a deployment. Okay, you need to specify what it is. Okay, we have a pod, controller and deployment. If it is controller, there are two types, replication controller RC and replication set RS. So those things need to be specified under that kind. And we have a tag called metadata, the third important thing, metadata, which contains the metadata information. Okay, so here the kind represents the objects that it is created. Okay, it is a port, or it is a controller, or it is a deployment. The version is static. Okay, so here this API version, always this version is static, version 1. You want to specify the version 1. And metadata, it will give all the metadata information about this. Okay, so entire metadata has been listed here, and the fourth important thing is the specification spec. The spec tag, you specify the specification where the actual information is. Okay, for example, where the image is, how to look for this container, all the things that will be here displayed here in this specification. So here, please make a note. Okay, so here, in this case of this version, okay, so here, what do you need to do? If it is a pod, okay, you can specify version 1, okay, in this API version. If it is a here service, you can specify version 1. If it is a replica set, or if it is a, okay, then you want to specify apps.slash/version1. Please make a note. If it is a deployment also, so here there are the replica set. Okay, in terms of we have already discussed in terms of controller, either a replica set or application controller, both the things for application set and also for application container. For this API version, you want to specify apps/v1. If the kind, if you specify, this is corresponding to this kind. If kind is port or if kind is service, version is v1. If the type is RS or RC, that is the replication container or replication set, and the API version is apps/v1. Similarly, for deployment, here apps/v1. So these are all the options that is associated with API version and kind. Okay, the metadata, you can specify the name. If it is a port, I can specify the name of the port. Okay, I can specify anything under this. I can specify a labels. Using labels, we can able to do some activity in later cases. Okay, under specification, the specification contains the important thing. It will contain the image name. Okay, it will give the name of the container, okay, the container name, the image name, all other stuff will be listed here. So these are all the four key components associated with the Kubernetes YAML file. Please make a note of it. Then we create a file, okay. So for launching a small application, how it will look like, whatever specification that need to contain, how to create that, okay. So let me create a file straight away here. Kubernetes YAML file. So four key components. So you can mention the file name is. So let me create a port. Okay, you can give any name. The file port-, okay, definition. You can give any name. port-definition1.yaml. Okay, let I create that file. Sudo vi port-definition1.yaml. Okay, so what we need to do, it need to start with the, okay, and it need to end up with triple dot. Intermediately, you can specify four things. First one, API version. Okay, so this API version colon, being it is a port, version 1. So next tag is a kind tag. Kind tag, it is a port. Okay, P stands for capital letter. So metadata. Under metadata, what you need to give, so okay, so you can give, you want to follow the same syntax, name one tag, and name is, you can make is a mail, Yeah, we're going to launch my web. Okay, so let me make it as my web iPhone port. Okay, so my web server iPhone port. This is the name that we assign to the port name. Please make a note. The name that we are giving under metadata is the port name. Okay, so you can give any labels. LA, BL. It is optional. You can give any name. Okay, anything that you can give. Okay. So you can give my application, ROM application, okay? So you can give anything under this type, big it is a front end, you can make it a, it is a front end. It is your option. The labels, laterally we will discuss how using this label we can do this thing. Okay, here this is alone important. The name is representing the name of the code, and you can specify anything in the label. And you need to give this specification. Under specification only, what you need to do? You want to specify the container. Okay, so container. You want to give the name of the container, iPhone name. What is the name of the container? Okay, you can make it as my web server. My web based on HTTP. Okay. So next, what you need to do, you want to give the image. What is the image? Colon, the image is HTTPD. Okay, so these are all the things that is associated. These are all the API version, being it is supported, the version is v1, and metadata, here is the name, okay, of this corresponding port. And this is the name that it is listed, container name that is listed, that this is the image. Okay, so after that, how to run this? Okay, so control once colon wq will take you to this prompt. So you can run this command itself. So to create kube control, okay, create the location -f. So here the file name, you want to specify the file name. Okay, port definition, y.yaml is the name of the file. Okay, so you can make a verification, kube control, get ports. So it will list the port, okay? So let me do this first. Let me copy, right click, copy. So let me open. And create less nothing sudo vi. What you need to do, you want to make it as code icon, any name. Okay, it is not mandatory that you need to give. I am giving this name code icon definition dot yml. Okay, sudo, you want to install sudo. Nothing is present. So because being it is a private cluster, okay, insert. Now you can find we have a port definition y.yml file. Okay, so how to run this? Before running this, let me get kube control get ports. Now we have one application server, one web server, and another database. Three instances of three containers are running. Okay, here what you need to do, I want to create kube port, create port definition dot yml. Okay, it will create another thing. Copy, go to this, paste it. Now this has been created. If we issue this get ports, now we can find this my web server. Okay, so iPhone port, is under the status of creating. Similarly, you can do anything. So let me create another code. Okay. So let me create another code. VI code -, deformation dot 2.yml. Let me create another YAML file. Okay, all the things are same. Simply copy, control C. Control V. Okay, app version. Here the kind is import. What we can do? Let me create the database. Okay, so let me create a database. The metadata. Okay, so instead of my database server, that I make it as okay Postgres. Okay, let me make it as so. Let I make my application Postgres. Okay, so Postgres dot post. You can give any name. Okay, under that labels, you can issue any name. Okay, so you can find it is a backend. Being it is a database, you can make it as a backend. Okay, the application is a Raman application. Raman database application type is backend. Here under specification you need to give this container. Here you want to give my database, my DB Postgres. Okay, you want to give the image here. Now the image is Postgres image. Okay, so this is the okay API version, kind code, metadata, my application Postgres. Okay, label. These are all the optional thing that you can give anything. Okay, it is not my application Postgres, my Postgres, anything that you can give label. And this is your charge. Okay, application Raman database application. It is a backend. This alone is important. Container name is okay. Image is Postgres. Let I open this. Right click, copy, open. Okay, so let we create another command. VI code -, it is not you want to give it start with the code definition. Okay, 2.yml. Insert mode. Right click, paste. Okay, escape colon wq. Now we have this code definition dot yml file. So let me create Kubernetes and create code definition 2.yml. okay, now it will create my Postgres code is created. Okay, so you can verify by simply getting Kubernetes get codes. Now we can find it is under the creation. These are all the ways by which you can define a YAML file of Kubernetes and to do automation. Here under the specification, if you want to do the same thing, MySQL, you can also specify the root password of MySQL under environmental. You can do a port mapping, everything that we can do. So let me create another two ports for our example. Okay, let me create a database. VI code -, definition 3.yml. Okay, So here this is my database. You can copy and paste the same thing. Control C, Control V. Okay, here the board is we are going to create a MySQL. API version is V1 and is 4. So here MySQL, okay, you can make it as MySQL 4. Labels RAM SQL database type is backend container here MySQL DB. Okay, then you want to give the image. So under the specification only now you want to give the name is MySQL DB. The image I want to give the image. So MySQL colon 5. This is the latest image and I need to give a password. Therefore env environmental, under environmental what I need to do, I need to give a another key and value pair. Name is mysql underscore root underscore password. Okay, so here the value that I need to give is value for this, let I make it as true. Okay, so that's all. Now you can give the additional parameter environment, and if you create the same thing, then for my name MySQL will be created. Simply right click and copy. Copy, go to the server. Okay, so you create a VA for iPhone definition read.yml. Okay, insert mode, right click, paste. Escape colon WQ. Okay, so here ls you have this way code iPhone definition dot YAML. You can create this, create code iPhone definition dot YAML. Now your MySQL code is created. Q control get codes will give you the information. Now you can find, so it is a my Postgres iPhone port. Okay, here the status error imageable. Okay, the image name that we have given might be wrong. Okay, let me verify. Under the image, we might have wrongly spelled the image name. Okay. Postgres image is correct, but alignment, alignment is also correct. Postgres double S, Postgres image name in top left up. So correct, Postgres is correct. This is the main Docker pull Postgres, and what is the error that we committed here? report. So now we can find. Now I will verify what is the reason. Now we can find. So the database MySQL port, if you want to connect, as you already told, to control-execute at the ID, you can specify the port name, it will make a connection. So these are all the ways by which we can create a YAML YAML file and you can do the needed things on top of it. Okay. So here the remaining the replicas, the replica containers, how to launch multiple services, how to scale up and scale down, everything will be taught to you tomorrow along with how to do this deployment. After Kubernetes, we have only one thing, that is the monitoring tool Nagios. Okay, it will be, the monitoring tool will be over either by tomorrow if it is possible to complete all the remaining Kubernetes stuff. If not, it will be, we will be having only one session on coming Saturday for discussing about this Nagios. Yeah. Automatically, you no need to worry about that. These instances will be dropped once you log off. Being it is okay. Free services, everything that we have created will be dropped off. Okay, Arun?
Okay, Raman.
So thank you. We meet again.